Alrighty guys, welcome back. Today we are going to talk about a little bit of karma.
A little bit of karma.
This is Culture Club's Karma Chameleon.
With Boy George.
Okay. From 1983.
Well, this is the 1983 version of it.
Yeah. So what's this about?
Don't even ask me why I picked this. I just was trying to think of something that I thought, you know, was just kind of upbeat. Okay. So I kind of like the song. And you know, that was really the only reason I thought about it. And then when I started looking at it a little deeper, came to realize that it's actually the 38th biggest selling single in the history of the United Kingdom. And I'm like, what?
38?
Really? The 38th biggest selling single of all time in the United Kingdom.
Okay.
And I'm like, really? This is, out of everybody, because you got to remember, you got the Beatles, you got the Stones, you've got
Queen.
You've got all kinds of people over there.
Yeah.
And Culture Club has number 38. Go figure. Elton John, all that stuff, you know, with all the number one hits and everything that they have.
Yeah. This is number 38.
I'm like going, holy smokes. Yeah. You know, so then I thought, you know, well, what is it about? In Karma Chameleon, well, you know what chameleons are. They change color all the time.
Yeah, and to blend in with their environments.
To blend in with the environment.
So they don't get eaten. And,
well, but it's true.
So they don't get eaten.
Okay, but it's true. But think about it in the human aspect. When you learn to blend in with whatever
society
versus standing out and bucking against them.
Yeah, okay. I'm more on the bucking against side, but so, I get what you're saying.
So as far as the chameleon goes, it's really all of us who, okay, I'm at a dinner party, I need to act like this. I'm over here, I need to act like this to fit in, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what he's saying with the karma part of it, and in the interview that he did.
Your actions will... You'll get karma for whatever action you give out.
Right. Everybody tries to blend in because they don't want any...
Bad karma.
They don't want any pushback.
Right.
The bad karma. They don't want any of that to come back and bite them, right? Mm-hmm. And he's saying, if you've ever seen Boy George...
Nope.
Okay, well, when you look at this, you're going to say, it's going to take you a while because it took me a while back when Culture Club first came out. I'm going, is this a guy or is this not? You know, just, I couldn't tell.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And, you know, George Allen O'Dowd is the guy's name. Okay. So definitely, you know, definitely believe him, but he was so, the makeup, the artistry, the whole bit. Okay. He didn't care what anybody else thought.
Yeah.
He was out to make music.
Yeah.
Okay. And he says that this song is the song is about the terrible fear of alienation that people have, the fear of standing up for one thing. It's about trying to suck up to everybody, which is the chameleon part. Okay. But basically, if you aren't true, if you don't act like you feel, so if you're not true to yourself, right? Then you get karma justice. That's nature's way of paying you back.
Mm.
And so the name started making much more sense.
After reading that,
you know. So anyway, I just thought that was real and very interesting. And it was just, you know, I still like the song just for the song.
Right.
You know, just for the music. And it's, you know, and it's catchy.
Okay.
Okay. But now it puts a little more perspective behind it. so anyway, but that's about it. That's about it. So, you know, let's
get started.
Let's do it.
All right.
Thank you.
The song is catchy. You know, this is totally off subject.
Okay.
I'm going to start this right out of the bat. This is totally off subject.
Okay.
Well, first, for a question first.
Be careful.
Yes.
Okay.
Were they from the United Kingdom?
Yeah.
Okay. Every single person who was wearing a football jersey was wearing an American football jersey.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Oakland Raiders and the San Francisco 49ers and, what was that? Was that a Cowboys jersey?
It was either that or the Colts.
It was probably a Colts jersey. I just found that extremely funny. It's a band from the United Kingdom, mm-hmm. and they're all wearing American football jerseys.
Mm-hmm.
I find that funny. number two.
Yeah.
I've heard this song before. I never saw that video with it.
Mm-hmm.
And if I wasn't told that he was a guy,
careful.
Yeah, I wouldn't know.
True.
Or
true.
I would have questions.
True. I agree. Back at this time. And this has nothing to do with anybody's gender identity. Okay?
Yep. Be careful.
Bite your lip. What I'm about to say doesn't have anything, you know, to do with anybody's gender identity, simply because of the fact that I'm a believer in you are who you are. Okay? That's, you know... That's where I stand on that. But as far as the artists, some of the artists back then,
mm-hmm.
if you had seen David Bowie when he first started out, you would have said the same thing. I'm sure that there are others, in fact, I know that there are others, that I just can't think of them right offhand. But, okay, you look at how flamboyant Elton John was. Okay? You look at...
Freddie Mercury.
Okay. There was a lifestyle that was especially that came out in the 80s. Okay. You know, I'm not... I can't sit here and say, hey, you know, this person's gay, this person's gay, this person's gay. I can't point fingers because you know what? I don't know. You have NFL football players... big, you know, beat the crap out of you guys who are gay. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So you don't know, and it really doesn't matter. So I don't know how much was artistry for the time. I don't know how much was lifestyle. But I don't think it really matters because the music was good.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way I look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Because... good music can come from anywhere and it can come from anybody.
Yeah.
So I don't look at it, you know, hey, you could say whatever you want to say about, you know, how they look and all this other kind of stuff, but I don't know anything about them, so I can't go any further than that, except that the music was good. And music is universal, no matter whose mouth it comes out of.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, and what I like about this is that if he was bucking the trend, because he obviously isn't wearing a jacket with a white shirt and a bow, or in a tie, like, you know, they did in the 60s, like almost every group did in the 60s, okay? He was not afraid to stand out there, okay?
And do that.
He was not going to be a chameleon because he felt that it was going to come back and bite him in the butt.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. It takes a lot of guts to do that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It really does. I don't know that I would have had the courage to do something like that.
No.
That's how I'm seeing Carmen Chameleon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And it makes much more sense to me. And I didn't really, I mean, I liked it. They had a couple of hits, and I liked their hits, but all the other other songs I went crazy about, so I really didn't listen to them all that much, you know, but now knowing what I know, hey, Boy George, more power to you, man. That's cool. Okay, so.
All right.
Hey, I'm good. My speech is over.
All right. All right. So, on to the announcements.
On to the announcements.
Hit it, guys.
Now it's time for the announcements.
All right, guys, don't forget that you can request your songs down below if you've got a song or songs that you would like to request for us to take a look at. There is a Google Form link down in the description below where you can click on that and, you know, submit your songs for us to, you know, for us to take a look at. This is for, you know, for everyone just to have a centralized place to go to, and for us to go to get your songs, you know, in this list and everything like that. Makes it super easy for us, and it makes it super easy for you. So make sure if you've got any songs to, you know, check out that link.
Yep.
Also, make sure to check out Coffee First Scheme Later up in the corner. We've got some vlogs and some challenges coming out, so make sure you tune in for that. As well as, you can always buy your t-shirts, hoodies, tank tops, etc. down below at the Bass Player Store, and that link down in the description below.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so sorry. And if you would like to become a Patreon member, that link is also down in the description below. You've heard me say all week what Patreon is, so I'm going to let you take a look back at those videos and hear me discuss Patreon for 4 days in a row.
There you go.
So, but that link is also down below. I do get to thank the following patrons who have pledged to make this video possible and for being awesome. That'd be Teresa Anderson, Hot Space, and Petro, Karen Barone, Sandy Thomas, Courtney Truax, Cindy Rice, and Don Kula. Thank you so much for your constant love and support during this tough time that we're all going through. And we're all, I hate to say this because this is so cliche for the time right now, but we're all in this together.
Mm-hmm.
And that is totally true. So thank you all so much for sticking around with us during all this. And we hope that you continue to stick around with us as we push forward and get through all of this.
Yes.
Also, last thing, guys, remember, at 1,000 subscribers, we will open up the P.O. Box. We are less than 100 away, so we are reeling in on that goal. And I know you can taste your peanut butter chocolate fudge right now and your snickerdoodles and all the other junk food that you're going to be sent from you-know-who. Feel free. But for all of you, for everyone else who may want to write a letter or a drawing or a Queen CD or any other CD or something else, if you want to send something, now's your opportunity.
Yep.
Or once we open the P.O. Box, then that's your opportunity. To send something if you would like, but in order to open up the P.O. Box, we have to get to 1,000 first. So make sure you subscribe down below so you don't miss what's to come, but to where you can also help us achieve that goal of 1,000. Like I said, like I've said in previous videos, if you don't want to help with this goal, but you just want to stay connected, stay involved, it is free and it is the easiest way to do that. So click it. now. I meant now. Anyway, anything else I'm missing today? Other than for them to click that subscribe button?
What is it?
I think it's the subscribe button.
You want them to click the subscribe button?
I want them to click the subscribe button.
The one on right there.
Yeah. Anything else I'm missing?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Unless you want to do a tutorial and show them where the mic button is and how to hit it.
No, not yet. Okay. Not yet. I have faith in them.
Okay.
Subscribe. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, guys, make sure to like this video. Smack that like button. Subscribe if you are new, and we'll see you all in the next one. Peace out, guys.